G'day, it's Robbie again. Well, in my last video, you saw how I melted down some aluminium in this little stainless steel pot, just using a standard butane torch, LPG torch, with the biggest burner on that I actually had. And it took about 5 minutes, took 5 minutes exactly to melt down aluminium in that. And that's good for very, very small jobs, you know, say firing up the big furnace. And in another video, you would have seen how I used that amount of aluminium to cast a handle onto a very small screwdriver. Real good. I did mention at the time in the last video that, you know, you could probably go twice as big with a standard LPG burner, you know, LPG gun, rather than, say, having to fire up the great big furnace out the backyard. And, of course, you can do it undercover as well inside. But what if you wanted to go a little bit bigger again and just use the LPG gun? Well, I had a reply back, some comments from one of my viewers, and referred me to a YouTube channel, and that channel also has a website, which is from a guy who's obviously very advanced in metal melting and casting, way more than me. I'm just a beginner. And he's got all sorts of furnaces on there and lots of information, and I'll put the link to the YouTube channel and his webpage in the description. Well worth visiting. Excellent, excellent sites. And one of the things he had on his webpage was a thing called a flower pot furnace. And what the flower pot furnace is basically he used flower pots to actually make a furnace. And he had two like this, one that way and one upside down sitting on that one. And he cut a hole in the bottom, and he had his butane torch blasting. When he had a dedicated burner, but you could use a big butane torch to blast into there, and the heat was trapped in the pot. And you would just put something like a tin inside, and I mean that would hold quite a bit, or you know, you don't have to fill it right up, but you could use half of it, say, which is a lot bigger than that little one. You put that in there, and then you put your lid on top and you fire up your burner, and the heat is trapped in there, and that should work, you know, a lot more efficiently than just heating it up without any surrounding you know, thing to trap the heat. I've got this one, which is a base, which could go on that way, and that would hold the heat as well. So I'm going to give it a go, just see how good this works. It should be really interesting. So I'll have to cut a hole in the pot without breaking it, which could be a bit tricky, but we'll give it a go. And yeah, we'll see how well it works. I think it's going to be, yeah, it should be pretty good. We'll find out anyway. So here's the pot, and here's the burner, and I've marked it with text to pen where the burner tip nozzle has to go in through there. So I've got to make a hole as big as the outside diameter of that black circle. And the plan is that I'll drill it through with a small masonry drill, and then I'll go out bigger without the hammer action. I don't want to go hammering on this. And then I'll work my way out bigger with the bigger masonry drills slowly, and then I'll finish off with a carbide burr in my air pencil die grinder and just grind it right out to the right shape. And that way we should be able to do it without hopefully breaking the pot. It's a pretty old pot, so well, it should be alright. So we'll give it a go, see what happens. So good. Now we'll go to next size. Just work our way up slowly on this, and hopefully we don't stuff it up. I'm not using the hammer action at all, otherwise I think it could be a bit severe. So we'll just work our way in slowly. I've got a pretty big
carbide tip drill that might go a fair way. Right.
I'm keeping the revs low. I don't want to rev it too hard, otherwise it might smash it. So far, so good. Yeah, I've got a big one, but I have to be super careful with this, all right? Take it slow. This may be pushing things a bit. We'll see. Finish it off now with the die grinder. I think that's getting close anyway. So we use the die grinder. This is my little kit that I've had for years. These are cheap. You get them off the internet, and they cost peanuts, but they're fantastic. You can do so many things with these things. It's just not funny. And even use them as a little miniature tool post grinder, as I've shown in my videos. But for this situation, we'll use a carbide burr. What have we got here? We'll use one of these. It's a coarse cylinder carbide burr. And we'll stick it in the little pencil die grinder, and we're good to go. Right, well, I'm going to use the vacuum cleaner at the same time so I don't get a lot of dust going everywhere. Oh, look at that, that's pretty good. So there you go, only took a few seconds to do that, or a few minutes. That should be pretty good. So good enough for the experiment. So now it's a matter of give it a go. So that'll go in like that, and then the pot goes in like that, and then the lid goes on like, well, either way, whatever you want to do. That. So, will this work? We'll see. Right, well, the tin I'm going to use has got one of those tear out tops, so I've got to get that lip off so that I can pour it out easily. So, once again, we'll use the air die grinder to do that. Just put a little cutting disc on there, a little friction disc, and that'll just take that off easy. Thank you.
Better take off the label, I suppose. If I can. So now we just put some aluminium in. This is from the last exercise. And clean other bits and pieces. This used to be a little bit of a lawnmower that's been cannibalised. So we'll just melt down enough for experiment. Won't worry about that bit for now. And see how quickly it works, how well it works. Right, we'll get it set up and we'll fire it up. To do this, I've got the LPG cylinder on the floor of the shed, hose coming up and across, and here's my standard gun sitting on a couple of bricks. I've got the pot on a brick, and inside we've got the tin with the goodies in it. So I'll light it up, put the lid on it, and we'll see how long it takes to melt that down. Should be interesting. To turn the gun back a little bit. It was putting too much gas in, and I've had to pull the lid back a little bit so it gets some airflow through a little bit, and now things are looking pretty hot, so we'll see how it goes. Right, well that worked pretty damn well, but I had to take the lid off, and then it got a lot hotter, a lot quicker. It was hopeless with the lid on, so all I did was just have the burner going in through the side of the pot, and it concentrated the heat at plenty good enough to melt that aluminium, and it did it really quickly. I didn't actually get a chance to time it because I was mucking around there trying it with the lid on and the lid back a bit, and you can see the heat has actually cracked the pot down the side here. It's pretty damn hot in there, but certainly it's way, way, way better with the lid off, and it just traps that heat in there. The burner works properly, it's getting enough air. It's not designed to actually work in a confined area like that, and it melted that aluminium fantastically well. So yeah, this is brilliant. This is a lot better than just doing it the way I did with just the gun on the little stainless container. This is way, way better. Really good. So let's see how it chips out of the new mould I made. It should be cooled down enough by now, I would think. How good is that? Check there. That is bloody brilliant. Ooh-wee.
Yeah, it's an ingot. Now, if I paint that gold and take it down to bank, I might get some money. Who knows? Awesome. Awesomeness. Absolute awesomeness. So there you go. Flower pot furnace works, but not the way I saw it on the web page. You definitely want to do it with the lid off. The pot got a few cracks in there. And also when you have the gun coming in, make sure the pot's as far away from the gun as possible so that you get the maximum flame effect. Otherwise, if you're too close, the heat doesn't, you're not getting maximum efficiency from the flame shape. So you really want a slightly bigger pot than this, if you can get it. Well, this worked good, really good. But move your tin can over to the back side of the furnace. So there you go, yeah, flower pot furnace definitely works brilliantly well, but not with the lid on. Take the lid off. Otherwise, you're not going to get the burner working correctly. It's not jetted for a sealed container, whereas the one the guy used in the video would have been for a sealed, mostly sealed container, would have been jetted for that, would have been jetted differently. But with an ordinary butane torch, yep, leave the lid off, and there's plenty of heat trap in there, and that will work damn good. So, I'm off to the bank now, see if I'll take that. It actually looks like silver. Maybe I'll take it as a silver ingot. Anyway, that's it, folks. See you next time. Cheers.